Hey guys, welcome to another GameMaker Roundup, where we take a look at cool things going on around the GameMaker Studio developer community. First thing this week, I'm actually a bit late to recording this, so this news isn't exactly hot off the press, but Yo-Yo Games recently pushed the 2.3 beta to the stable channel. Many GameMaker users appear to be super excited about the release and eager to make the most of it. If you've been living under a rock and didn't already hear about it, GameMaker 2.3 adds such things as animation curves, sequences complete with a timeline editor, a revamped asset browser, an overhauled manual, as well as additions to the GML scripting language, including functions, methods, structs, and chain accessors. So, if you haven't tried it out already, I highly encourage you to download the update and try it for yourself. And over on the GameMaker Marketplace, user by the name BigSquareSmall has released an update for their tool called True Water and Jellies. The tool makes use of shaders and liquid fun physics particles to produce some solid-looking simulations of water and jelly-like substances. The update adds support for various new effects such as foam, transparency, and distortion. It also adds sleek color mixing and the ability to easily delete particles as needed. As of recording this, all of its reviews are shining 5 stars, so I highly suggest jumping on over if your project could use a splash of awesome. And for you hipsters out there, True Water and Jellies can also be downloaded from itch.io. Speaking of hipsters, have you ever wanted to break away from the norm and run GameMaker on Linux? Well, with a bit of work, you can. Over on the GameMaker community forum, user by the name T the Creator has a topic showing how to get GameMaker Studio 2 to work with the Linux OS. It is listed as having been tested on Ubuntu, Mint, and Elementary, but other Linux distributions should also work with appropriate tweaks. Be warned, however, that this is not suggested for everyone, especially those unfamiliar with Linux, as it does require some technical Linux savviness, but it could be a very valid solution for those already using Linux as their daily driver. I also feel a need to highlight Audio Paprika's reply to the topic, mentioning that .NET 48 needs to be installed in order for the mouse to work properly with GameMaker 2.3. What is .NET 48? I don't know. But if GameMaker on Linux sounds of interest to you, be sure to check out the video description for links about the relevant information. In other news, developer by the name Refresher Towel has written an in-depth tutorial showing how to design some sweet-looking particle effects using GameMaker's built-in particle system. They nicely lay out their method for producing visually stunning wormholes, dazzling trail effects, and general awesome. Their hope is to inspire other developers with helpful knowledge in order to push them on their way to making better-looking particles for their own projects. Also worth noting, Refresher Towel has been working on their own game called Spacelingers, a gravity-based puzzle game which makes heavy use of the particle techniques mentioned in their tutorial. And honestly, even the custom level editor for this project is looking pretty sweet. Good stuff. And to round up this week, I'd like to give a shout out to developer Chinny Kian from Singapore, who recently finished up work on a Nintendo Switch port of their vertical jumpless platformer called Serious Scramblers. Fall skillfully down a pit filled with the shrieking screams of giant worms while traversing tricky traps trying to turn you topside. It is currently available for purchase from Nintendo's eShop for only a couple of bucks and a mere 57 megabyte download. Why not consider making it a part of your on-the-go library? And if you're not a part of the cool Nintendo Club, you can also download Serious Scramblers over on Steam, and once again, itch.io for you hipsters. Well guys, that's it for this week's GameMaker Roundup. I'm glad you stopped by to see what's going on, and I truly hope that you found it to be a brighter part of your day. Be sure to check out links in the video description for anything you found to be of interest, and also be sure to check out the quick GIFs at the end of this video to see more of the cool things being made by the broader GameMaker community. Alright guys, until next time, blessings.